Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us on Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. Russia has taken major steps in augmenting their military prowess, from new battle tank T14 Armata to developing the world's most powerful ICBM Sarmat. Russian military is expanding its capabilities. Russia has also been putting a lot of attention on tactical nukes. To counter them, the U.S. Army is taking another look at a devastating weapon. The Kinetic Energy Projectile, or KEP, is a tungsten-based charge moving at 3 times the speed of sound that can destroy anything in its path. It was first tested by the Air Force and Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in 2013. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Kinetic Energy Projectile of U.S. is a strong answer to Russia's tactical nuke.
Number 5.
Why would the U.S. military, which has put untold billions of dollars into precision weapons over several decades, need such a blunt and terrifying weapon? The answer is to counter small nuclear weapons of Russia. A tactical nuclear weapon, TNW, or non-strategic nuclear weapon, is a nuclear weapon which is designed to be used on a battlefield-level military situations, mostly with friendly forces in proximity and perhaps even on contested friendly territory. This is opposed to strategic nuclear weapons, which are designed to be mostly targeted in the enemy interior, away from the warfront, against military bases and cities to damage the enemy's ability to wage war. Tactical nuclear weapons include gravity bombs, short-range missiles, artillery shells, landmines, depth charges, and torpedoes, which are equipped with nuclear warheads. Also in this category are nuclear-armed, ground-based or shipborne surface-to-air missiles, SAMs, and air-to-air missiles. The yield of tactical nuclear weapons are generally lower than that of strategic nuclear weapons, but larger ones are still very powerful.
Number 4.
Major General William Hiss, the Army's Director of Strategy, Plans and Policy, said, "The Russians maintain their tactical nuclear stockpile in ways the U.S. have not." Potomac Institute head Philip Carber, who helped write the Pentagon's Russian New Generation Warfare Study, offered a bit more explanation. While the United States retains just a few of its once large arsenal of tactical nukes, Carber estimates that Russia currently has anywhere from 2,000 to 5,000 of the weapons. He added, "Look at what the Russians have been doing in low fission, high fusion, sub-kiloton tactical nuclear technology. It appears that they're putting a big effort in both miniaturizing the warheads and using sub-kiloton low-yield warheads."
Number 3.
By shrinking the warhead, one can shoot it out of a wider variety of guns, including potentially 152mm tank cannons. Barber said, "They've announced that the follow-on tank to the Armata will have a 152mm gun missile launcher. They're talking about it having a nuclear capability." And you go, "You're talking about building a nuclear tank. A tank that fires nukes." Well, that's the implication. Though the use of tactical battlefield nuclear weapons, even very low-level ones, is not part of official Russian military doctrine, but it is a capability they're increasingly eager to show off to intimidate neighbors and adversaries. Barber added, "They certainly exercise the use of those weapons in many of their exercises, including the one that participated in the parking of 30,000 to 40,000 soldiers on the Ukrainian border right before the 2014 invasion of Crimea. That coercive intimidation is part of their design." And while even Soviet generals may have shied away from using tactical nukes, Putin's military is a lot more inclined philosophically to see the utility of them.
Number 2.
Kinetic energy projectile is a super dense, super fast projectile that operates free of complex systems and volatile chemicals. Whether dropped from the sky or fired from a cannon, the principle behind these weapons is the same: hitting the enemy with something very hard and very dense, moving very fast. The principle of the kinetic energy penetrator is that it uses kinetic energy, which is a function of its mass and velocity, Kinetic energy equals half mass times velocity. To impact target with lethal effects. To maximize mass, KEP uses the densest metals, which is one of the reasons depleted uranium or tungsten carbide is used. Major General Hiss said a few weeks ago at the Booz Allen Hamilton Direct Energy Summit, "Think of it as a big shotgun shell." But unlike a shotgun shell, Hiss said the KEP moves at incredible speeds of Mach 3 to Mach 6. Randy Simpson, a weapons program manager at Lawrence Livermore National Lab, explains that kinetic energy projectiles are warheads that take advantage of high terminal speeds to deliver much more energy onto a target than the chemical explosives they carry would deliver alone. Mr. Hiss added, "The way that they have designed it is quite devastating. I would not want to be around it. Not much can survive it. If you're in a main battle tank, if you're a crew member, you might survive, but the vehicle will be non-mission capable. And everything below that level of protection will be dead. That's what I'm talking about."
Number 1.
The kinetic energy projectile may become a staple of modern warfare soon, as per most experts. The absence of explosive propellants to store and handle, as well as the lower cost of projectiles compared to conventional weaponry, comes as a great advantage. KEP will be used as an advanced conventional precision effect warhead for prompt strike capability. US and Russia has taken different routes in terms of battlefield level weapons. The Russians are going with tactical nukes, which will cause widespread destruction, whereas America is going with a more precise strike option. For Russia, it makes sense as they already have a huge stockpile of tactical nukes. From America's standpoint, KEP fits well into the larger picture of augmenting precision strike options with this highly destructive technology. It remains to be seen how this duel pans out in the future.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.